Recorded Books presents an unabridged recording of Mr. Putter and Tabby Write the Book by Cynthia Rylant, narrated by John McDonough and directed by Ben Ruggiero.
1. An Idea. In the winter, a big snow always came to Mr. Putter's house. Mr. Putter and his fine cat, Tabby, liked big snows. But they couldn't go out in them. They were too old. Mr. Putter might slip and break something. Tabby might catch a bad cold. They didn't mind staying in, though, because Mr. Putter's house was so cozy. It had nice, soft chairs. It had velvet pillows. It had a fireplace. Staying in was all right when everything was so soft and velvety and warm. One day, when Mr. Putter and Tabby were inside for a big snow, Mr. Putter got an idea. His idea was to write a book. He had everything a writer needed: a soft chair, a warm fire, and a good cat. And he had a pen and plenty of paper. "I have always wanted to write a mystery novel," Mr. Putter said to Tabby. So he brought out lots of paper, lit the fire, plumped his chair, and got ready to begin. First, he had to think of a title. He thought, and thought, and thought. Finally, he told Tabby, "I shall call my book The Mystery of Lighthouse Cove." It was a very good title. It was full of mystery. As a boy, he had read lots of books with titles like that. Mr. Putter was so pleased, he decided to fix a snack. He went into the kitchen and fixed a big apple salad, a pan of corn muffins, some custard pudding, and a cheese ball. Mr. Putter spent 3 minutes on his title and 4 hours on his snack. Then he took a nap. Mystery writing was not easy work. Two, Chapter One. On the second day that he was a mystery writer, Mr. Putter had a nice long breakfast with Tabby of oatmeal and tea. Then he settled down to write again. But first, he had to stoke the fire. Then he had to clean Tabby's ears. Then he had to find a sweater. Then he had to move his chair closer to the window. Then he had to move it back. Then he settled down again. He was ready to write. Mr. Putter looked at the walls, and he thought. He thought and thought and thought. Finally, he wrote Chapter One. He began to think some more. As he was thinking, he looked out the window. A rabbit was in the yard. "Such a nice rabbit," Mr. Putter said to Tabby. The rabbit made him think of Easter, and Easter made him think of boiled eggs. He decided to fix a snack. He went into the kitchen and fixed 20 boiled eggs and a vegetable stew. Mr. Putter spent 1 minute on Chapter One and 3 hours on eggs and stew. Then he took a bath. Then he took a nap. Mystery writing wore him out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.